Is credit counseling an option? Well, it can be. But what you need to know about credit counseling is that it's outside of the scope of the law in many cases in terms of, and I'm not saying it's illegal, I'm saying that it's outside of the scope of the bankruptcy code, the judicial system, a system basically of, we have an expectation when it comes to the court system. We have an expectation when it comes to legal matters. Kind of know what the outcome is going to be. With credit counseling, it's a bit of a gamble in terms of what is actually going to happen. It's pure negotiation. The creditors don't have to negotiate for, they don't have to say, yeah, we'll accept less than what you owe us just because somebody asked us to. Many times they will. And in fact, if you become 90 days late, you'll probably get a letter from your creditors saying, hey, you owe $25,000, we'll accept $12,000 if you write us a check for $12,000. No, if you had $12,000, you probably wouldn't be late on your credit card. So that's probably not realistic. So a credit counselor might negotiate something out. But here's the main reason I don't like credit counseling. I had a client years ago. She felt that morally the right thing to do was to do her best to pay back her creditors. And so she went to a credit counseling agency and they set up a repayment plan. She was in it for 5 years. She paid back 50 cents on the dollar. She did this for 5 years. And then she came to me and said, it's been 5 years, I paid off all my debts, I want to buy a house. Pulled her credit report and I said, okay, I'm going to need all the documentation because your credit report is completely, completely a mess. And that's one of the problems with credit counseling is you don't have a document like you do with bankruptcy to say, here's a schedule of creditors. Because as a lender, I need your schedule of creditors. After you file for bankruptcy, I'm going to need your schedule of creditors. I'm going to need a copy of the discharge signed by the judge to show that it actually went through. And I might even, most of the time people throw that stuff away, which I don't understand why, but people seem to. So I end up going down to the federal courthouse and getting it for them anyway. But I need that schedule of creditors because I need to know what was included in your bankruptcy so that you don't owe it. So I might have to update your credit report, whatever it is that I'm going to have to do. I look at that stuff and then we get it taken care of. With credit counseling, I don't have the luxury of a schedule of creditors. I don't have that. I don't have the luxury of a discharge signed by a judge. Basically, I have this haphazard credit report that I'm just hoping everything was included and negotiated out, and I hope that maybe the credit counselor has some paperwork. Well, in that particular case, everything, all the unsecured debts were taken care of. But there was a $9,000 judgment that was not taken care of, so she spent 5 years in credit counseling. Now we've got a $9,000 judgment, and guess what? If you have a judgment against you, you are not going to be buying a house anytime soon until that judgment is taken care of. So basically, she spent 5 years thinking that she was doing the right thing, paying 50 cents on the dollar. Now, I'm not an attorney. I went to law school. I took bankruptcy law, so I know a little bit about bankruptcy. And I will say, just in analyzing her circumstances, I would guess that she probably would have paid a lot less in a Chapter 13 bankruptcy. If she was so hung up about paying something back to her creditors, she would have been much better off in Chapter 13. She probably would have paid like 10 or 15 cents on the dollar. I don't know. But the reality is that she's really not in any better circumstance at this point in time with a $9,000 judgment after she's completed her credit counseling because the credit, and you know what the credit counselor said? Oh yeah, they weren't willing to participate. So that's okay. Apparently they thought it was. It's not okay. This lady wanted to get back on track to buy a house. She thought she was doing the right thing. It did not work out in her favor. If she would have gone the bankruptcy route, or at least had sat down with a bankruptcy attorney, that's all I care for consumers to do is find out what your options are, see how it applies to your specific circumstances, because you may have a bunch of assets that could be an issue for you to file for a Chapter 7. Maybe it's not the right move. It's not for everybody. But in some cases, it is. And in her situation, it would have been. She would have bought a house within 2 years if she would have just filed for Chapter 7, which she would have qualified for. But guess what? The credit counselor told her how bad bankruptcy was. Well, I guess you have to make that choice for yourself in terms of, is it better off for me to repay debt for 5 years and then at the end of 5 years still owe a $9,000 judgment that she actually thought was included? It wasn't. It's a lack of communication there. You're not going to have that in the bankruptcy process. Or to be able to file bankruptcy, utilize federal law, and buy again in 2 years, which do you think is better? It's up to you to decide. It's not for me to decide. So that's my feeling about credit counseling, is buyer beware. You are outside of the scope of what we would expect in a legal process, and anything can go. And a lot of times what I find is when people do go the credit counseling route, you know what happens? They jump, they bail. They stay in it for like maybe 3 months, maybe 6 months, and then they realize, gosh, you know, this isn't going the way it was sold to me. And so they, you know what they end up doing? They get out of credit counseling and then they file for bankruptcy. And a lot of times the response I get from people who file for bankruptcy is, I just wish I would have done it sooner. I just wish I would have done it before I liquidated my 401k, before I liquidated my IRA. Because you know what? You're probably going to be able to keep that in a bankruptcy. If a credit counselor tells you to pull money out of your 401k or your IRA to pay back a debt, don't do it. Go talk to a bankruptcy attorney and get the proper advice that you need.